students, under chapter structural organization in animals, in our last class we were discussing anatomy of frog. We only discussed digestive system and that is respiratory system in frog. Today we will continue with the circulatory system and remaining like excretory system and reproductive system of the frog. Okay, so one by one we will discuss. Now we have to discuss circulation in frog, that is how blood is circulated. Frog has two types of body fluids. One is blood, other one is lymph. See, one thing you should remember, frog has almost all 99% all the systems, body systems similar to human beings, like all the systems like circulatory system, neural system, then excretory system, reproductive system, it is almost similar to human beings, 99% similar. So same like human beings, frog also has two types of body fluids, one is blood, the other one is lymph. So frog has, for blood circulation, it has a muscular organ, that is heart, and heart has three chambers here. Three chambers are in heart. There is no diagram given in the textbook, but for your basic understanding I will just draw one structure. Okay, so it will have two auricles. This is auricle 1, this is auricle 2. Okay, so this is left auricle and this is right auricle. Why? Because if I stand in front of you, this is my right side, this is my left side. For you it looks like opposite, but this is left side and this is right side. Two auricles are there and only one ventricle is present. Only one ventricle is present. So heart is a muscular organ with three chambers in frog. Like two auricles are there, two upper chambers, and only one ventricle is present. Then heart is covered externally by external cover, that is called pericardium, same like human beings. Heart is covered by a muscular covering, that is called pericardium. Name only says peri means sides, cardio means heart, pericardium. So then very important what you should know is some different structures are there in heart of frog. That is, one triangular structure is there. Triangular structure is there near the right auricle. Okay, so that is not there in human beings. You see, that is one triangular structure is there near the right auricle, that is called sinus venosus. Sinus venosus, isn't venosus means veins. Okay, sinus venosus present at the right side, and these are nothing but veins. Sinus venosus is veins. So veins like vena cava, same like human beings, superior and inferior vena cava, they will collect carbon dioxide mixed blood from the body parts, from all the tissues. Waste carbon dioxide will be collected and vena cava or veins will pass the carbon dioxide mixed blood to right auricle through this conical structure, that is called sinus venosus. Okay, that you have to remember. Then this type of system is called venous system or venous circulation. So this is called, because veins are involved in collecting the blood here, so it is called venous system. Okay, then on the left side of the heart, where left side of the heart, okay, there oxygenated blood comes there. Then from there oxygenated blood goes to ventricle. Then ventricle has one special structure. Through that oxygen mixed blood goes to all the body parts. All the body parts or tissues or cells of the body. Okay, for that it has conus arteriosus. Special structure here in the ventricle that is called conus arteriosus. So same like this is venosus means veins, this is arteriosus means arteries. You know, in human beings also artery, that is largest artery is aorta. Aorta supplies oxygenated blood to all the body parts. Same like that. But this is conus arteriosus is a special structure. Same like sinus venosus. Venosus means veins, this is artery. So artery is meant for supplying oxygenated blood to all the body parts. So this conus arteriosus is present in the ventricle. Through that, oxygenated blood goes to all the body parts. Okay, and this type of system where blood, oxygenated blood goes to all the body parts, this is called arterial system. That is called venous system because veins are involved in this. This is arteries are involved in this, so it is called arterial system. That means right side of the body it is venous system and left side of the body it is arterial system. Okay, this is very important what you should know. Then, like blood passes through the circulation where blood is there, blood is transported to all the body parts by heart. So, circulatory system includes in frog, heart for pumping blood, then that pumped blood passes through blood vessel, and what is transported in the blood vessel? Blood. So these are the three parts of circulatory system, you know, blood, blood vessel and heart, you know, because blood comes to heart and heart pumps blood through blood vessels. Then they have one more body fluid as we already discussed, that is lymph. So lymphatic system includes lymph, then lymphatic vessel, meaning how blood passes through blood vessel, which is a tube-like structure, like that lymph passes through lymphatic vessel. Okay, like tube-like structure where lymph passes. Then here and there will be lymphatic or nodules. Lymphatic nodules. Nodules means, you know, like suppose this is a lymph vessel where it has produced a branch here. Here and there you will see one knot-like structure like this. In the whole body where lymph is transported to whole body, here and there near the on the lymph vessel there will be knot-like structure that is called lymph nodes. Lymph nodes. Okay, in second year biology you will learn what is the importance of lymph node we are going to discuss. So you should know that circulatory system where blood is involved, it includes three parts. Heart, because blood comes to heart, then heart pumps blood through blood vessel. Like lymph passes through lymphatic vessel, and here and there on the lymphatic vessel there will be node-like structure that is called lymph nodes. Okay, so this is about circulatory system in frog. Then what about blood? What are the components of blood? We will see. Where did I keep this duster? Anyway. Thank you. I told you frog has systems almost similar to human beings, like that in the components of blood. If you see components of blood means parts of blood, what is there in blood of frog? Like same like human beings, it has RBCs, that is red blood corpuscles, it has WBCs, that is white blood corpuscles, then it has plasma which is straw color, then it has platelets, thrombocytes. Same, RBCs are called erythrocytes, other name. WBCs are called leukocytes and platelets are called thrombocytes. You already know this, no need to explain. In other chapter we have learnt in detail. So same like human beings, even our blood also contains same thing, red blood corpuscles, white blood corpuscles, plasma and platelets. Then what I was saying, okay, so the blood, what is the main function? Blood carries nutrients, gases and water. Blood carries nutrients, that is food. Food will be transported to different part of the body through blood. Then it transports gases like carbon dioxide, oxygen will be transported to all the body parts through blood. Then water, because most of the part of blood contains water only, so water reaches all the body parts, no? That is also through blood. So this is about a circulatory system. But one more important thing what you should know is something different. So see, with respect to circulatory system only, something different, that is venous connection is there, means veins, connection of veins are there between liver and intestine. That means liver and intestine are connected by veins, where transport of blood is transported from liver to intestine and intestine to liver through a blood vessel, and that system is called hepatic portal system. Portal system, name only says. Word hepatic refers to liver, because liver cells are called hepatic cells, kidney cells are called renal cells, heart cells are called cardiac cells. You already know this, I have explained so many times, maybe more than 10 times I have explained, you already know. So hepatic port means tube, hepatic word refers to liver. So through the tube blood is passed to intestine. Okay, through this tube, blood from the liver is passed to intestine, and from the intestine it is passed to liver. So the tube, what is there, that is called hepatic portal system. Then from the kidney also, kidney and intestine are also connected. Means blood from the kidney is passed to intestine, and from the intestine blood is passed to kidney through a tube, you know, that tube. That system is called renal portal system. Simple, because word renal refers to kidney. Word hepatic means liver. So blood from liver goes to intestine, and blood from intestine comes to liver through hepatic portal system. Then from the kidney to intestine, from intestine to kidney, blood passes, that is called through a tube called renal portal system. So with this circulatory system in frog, we discussed in detail without leaving a word also. Now next part in anatomy of frog. We have to discuss now neural system, then we have to discuss excretory system, then we should discuss reproductive system. Now we will see excretory system in frog. Same like human beings, a pair of kidneys, but I can show you the chart where you can see reproductive system and excretory system, both are in same chart, both are in the same chart, you can see. I hope this is visible to you, otherwise I have to zoom it. If you want, I can zoom it. Not visible, so I will just focus. Now yes, slightly. Yes, I think now you can see clearly. Yes. So this is actually a diagram of reproductive system in male and female, but here only you can see excretory system also, because there are pair of kidneys. You can see here this part, this and this, they have written kidney here. You can see they have written kidney. This is kidney, okay. So kidney, a pair of kidneys are there in both male and female. This is male, this is female. Kidneys, okay. You can see there, then you can see that this is a urinogenital tract. Urinogenital means urine also comes through the same tube, even sperms also comes to same tube. Sperm, which is a male gamete, male sex cell, that also comes through same tube, then urine also comes through same tube, okay. But in female, excretory system is slightly different. You see where this is kidney, where ureter is there, where this is the only tube for meant for passing urine, but egg doesn't pass through this. Female gamete doesn't pass. Okay, this is a separate tube, and for female gamete separate tube is there. You can see that is oviduct. Ova means egg, duct means tube. So egg comes through separate tube, then urine comes through separate tubes. These are two separate tubes, you can see there, but here it is only one tube. There is no separate tubes, where single tube is there, where urine also passes here, sperm also passes here. But in female urine passes through ureter, then egg passes through oviduct. Oviduct means, ova means egg, duct means tube, okay. So that is a difference what you see. Then so from the kidney you can see here the urine and sperm both will come to a common tube, that is rectum. Then here this is called cloaca, that is common opening, you already know this. And this is an opening called cloacal aperture through which urine goes out. Urine and sperm both will go out. Then this is a urinary bladder. You know, urinary bladder is bag-like structure, muscular bag-like structure meant for collection of urine. So kidney filters blood, then that filtrate, that is urine, comes through urinogenital tract to cloaca, and from there it will be stored in urinary bladder. Then from the urinary bladder through cloaca, that is the opening, urine goes out. I repeat, kidney filters blood, then filtrate, that is urine, comes through the tube urinogenital tract, then it comes to cloaca, then it will get stored in urinary bladder. From the urinary bladder through cloaca, urine passes out. Okay, here you see in female kidney produces urine comes through ureter. Here it is urinogenital tract, because it is common for sperm and urine, but here it is only urine. So only urine passes through ureter, then it comes to cloaca, stored in urinary bladder, same like this. Then through cloacal opening urine passes. Okay, so this is about removal of nitrogenous waste.
okay, then
same like human beings, each kidney is composed of millions of filtration units called nephrons. You already know, same like human beings. So
I can write here, no, visible.
So each kidney contains millions of nephrons, also called as uriniferous means, name only says, uriniferous means urine bearing or urine containing tubes. Uriniferous tubules means urine producing tubules, also called nephron. You already know this. It's also called nephrons. Same like human kidney. That is, even in human kidney also, each kidney contains millions of filtration unit. The function is they filter blood and they produce urine. So now zooming is enough. So now we will focus on the board. Yes, now you can see the board. I can write here. So I was saying, each kidney contains millions of filtration unit. What this filtration unit will do? They will filter little quantity of blood and they produce urine. So they are called uriniferous, means urine producing tubes. So they are called nephrons. You know, already you know, you have learnt in other chapter, that is neural excretory products and their elimination, all in detail you have learnt it. So same like human beings. That's why I said most of the system in frog, it is almost similar to human beings. Same like human beings, frog also excretes urea.
So frog is ureotelic animal.
We are also ureotelic only because we also release urea along with urine. So as you know, there are three types of animals based on excretory products. Like if animals release ammonia, they are ammonotelic. If they release uric acid, they are uricotelic. If they release urea, then they are ureotelic. Human beings release urea along with urine. So because our urine contains urea, so we are ureotelic. So frog also, same like human beings, frog also releases urea along with urine. So frog is also ureotelic animal. So urea is a nitrogenous waste which frog removes. Okay, so this is what you should know. Then neural system, if you see neural system, similar to human beings, that also we will see. There are two types of control and coordination, same like human beings. One is brain controls it by producing neurons, that is called neural control and coordination. One more is there, frog also contains endocrine gland, same like human beings, like it contains pituitary gland, but no hypothalamus, no pineal gland. Pituitary gland is there, then thyroid gland is there, thymus is there, then adrenal gland is there, then gonads, that is reproductive organs are there. Those are all endocrine glands. So they also produce hormones, same like humans. I told you, similar to humans. So we will discuss that now. Control and coordination in frog. So all the body processes are controlled by two ways here, same like humans. One way is
neural control, that is brain controls it, and second way is chemical control, that is called endocrine system, right? That is endocrine glands, which produces hormones and controls it, same like human beings. So if you see a neural control in frog, neural control in frog, here also, even in frog also, brain is there, and three types of nervous system. You see three types of nervous system, same like human beings, that is central nervous system, CNS, then peripheral nervous system, PNS, then ANS, that is autonomic nervous system, same like human beings. Then central nervous system has two parts, you already know this, brain and spinal cord. Then peripheral nervous system has two types of neurons, that is cranial nerves and spinal nerves. Cranial nerves, then spinal nerves, already you know this. But the difference is very interesting, is cranial nerves in human beings, it is 12 pairs, totally 24. But in frogs, it is cranial nerves are 10 pairs, 20 difference. Okay, spinal nerves in human beings is 31 pairs. Then ANS is there, again same, again it will have two types, like sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system, similar to human beings. So difference what you see is cranial nerves in human beings, it is 12 pairs, but here cranial nerves are 10 pairs. Very important to note difference between frog and human beings nervous system. Okay, so that is one, sympathetic, parasympathetic. Then brain is covered by bony case called the brain box, that is cranium, you already know, same like humans. Human brain is also covered by bony case, that is called cranium, you know, that's same like that. Here also brain is covered by a bony case for protection, that is cranium or skull, same like human beings, not no much difference except 10 pairs of cranial nerves. Okay, then again brain is divided into three parts, that is forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. Brain is divided into three parts, forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. You already, we have learned about human beings, human brain already we have learned. So forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain, three parts are there, similar to human beings. Okay, the forebrains will have olfactory lobes, cerebral hemispheres, olfactory lobes, then cerebral hemispheres, you know what is the meaning of it, that is brain is cerebrum is divided in the middle into two parts, that is hemispheres. So olfactory lobes are there, then that is to sense smell. Okay, then cerebral hemispheres are there, then diencephalon is there. You can say diencephalon also, or you can say diencephalon also. Diencephalon, which is a part of forebrain. Okay, then same like human beings. Midbrain is characterized by optic lobes. Midbrain has optic lobes, that is meant to see the things. Whenever we see some things, whenever frogs will see something, they will sense, means they will understand what is that, because the message from the eyes will go to brain and brain will interpret and brain will understand what kind of object it is. Okay, then hindbrain contains cerebellum and medulla oblongata. cerebellum and medulla oblongata. We don't see pons here. Pons we don't see here. Only cerebellum and medulla oblongata is there in the hind brain. Then very important is medulla oblongata passes through tube like structure that is called foramen magnum. There is no neck in frog. Otherwise in human beings we know that brain, no, so spinal cord passes through the medulla oblongata, continues, okay, then in a tube like structure there, what is that? That is called foramen magnum. So medulla continues to pass through foramen magnum. Connection between the medulla oblongata and spinal cord. So spinal cord is connected in the neck portion, then it goes to vertebral column, backbone. So in between last hindbrain and spinal cord, the connection is there, that is called foramen magnum. Then it goes to spinal cord, that is a neck portion, that is a cylindrical structure through which nerves will pass, cranial and spinal nerves. That is here, if you cut the neck and see inside, cylindrical structure is there, through that cranial nerves pass. So connection between medulla oblongata and spinal cord is foramen magnum. Then from the spinal cord it continues, spinal cord continues downwards in the back portion, that is backbone, that is called vertebral column. Vertebral column. So this is one way of control, that is neural control. Then it has chemical control also by producing endocrine glands. We have already learned this in human physiology, so we already know this. So chemical control is there. Chemical control or coordination by endocrine glands, which produces hormones. By producing hormones it can control a variety of functions. Like it has the prominent endocrine glands are pituitary, thyroid, parathyroid. Pituitary gland is there, thyroid gland is there, same like humans, parathyroid you see, then you see thymus gland there, same like human beings, thymus gland. Then we see pineal body, pancreatic islets, like pineal glands we call pineal body, islets of Langerhans, that is endocrine part of pancreas, pancreatic islets also we see. Then adrenal gland present just above the kidney is also present in frog. Then gonads, that is reproductive organs, all these acts as an endocrine gland. Okay, pituitary is there, thyroid gland is there, parathyroid is there, thymus gland is there, pineal gland or pineal body is there, pancreatic islets are there, then adrenal gland is there, gonads are there. These are the endocrine glands. They produce hormones. By producing hormones they control the body. So one part of control is brain controls all the body work, body functions. What brain cannot control will be controlled by endocrine glands by producing hormones. Okay, so this is about control and coordination, that is nothing but nervous system, neural system and endocrine system in frog. So in our next class we will learn about sensory organs of frog, that is sense organs. Then we are going to discuss reproductive organs in frog in detail. Okay, so keep watching my classes. Thank you.